The scientific discipline of naming plants is 250 years old, and artists have been involved from the very start of this discipline. Botanical illustrations aren't just art. They communicate precisely what's needed for the taxonomic science, and people can compare species very easily when the botanical artist draws attention to what's important.
A lot of the specimens that we work from are collected in the field by the botanists, and they're dried and pressed in a herbarium press. So we need to bring those specimens back to life using our drawing skills. We do two main types of work, pen and ink illustrations and watercolour illustrations. And they're often for botanists, so we describe new species of plants for the scientists. And we do colour work for Curtis's Botanical magazine. Every time we draw a plant, we're making judgments about what we're depicting. We have quite a lot of botanical knowledge, so we're able to highlight the most important features of a plant, get rid of any detail that's not important, and of course, reconstruct the specimen. You have quite a responsibility when you're working for the scientists on specimens, because you need to show the absolute truth. Accuracy of scale is very, very important. Everything is measured, and we make sure that the colour, for example, is 100% correct and true to life. I love being a botanical artist because I get to work with nature every day, whether it's working from a herbarium specimen or being out in the gardens at Kew and being part of that scientific discovery process.
Photography and filming and modern imaging are great, but they can never replace the scientific work and information prioritization that an artist does. Lucy sees everything and she records it meticulously. Seeing Lucy's drawing is like suddenly seeing my plant in a completely new light.